Don't just toss your UX data into a chart and share it out, hoping that your viewers will see what you want them to see. When creating explanatory data visualizations intended to communicate a takeaway or a finding, we want to carefully design our charts so that it supports the point that we're trying to make. We can do this by using contrast to draw the viewer's attention to the finding. There are three important tools for helping viewers understand your point: color, titles, and callouts. Color is a powerful tool for directing attention to the data series or values that are most important for the takeaway you're trying to convey. Show those key series or values in a brighter, bolder color than the others. Economist Jonathan Schwabish offers a great tip for using color in charts. Start with gray. By that, Schwabish means that you should intentionally make all the elements in your chart grayscale. Then strategically add color to highlight the values or series that are most important for your chart's intended point. For example, let's follow Schwabish's advice for a chart showing success rates from a quantitative usability test and start with gray. When all the bars in a chart are the same color, in this case, gray, nothing really stands out. Let's imagine that our goal is to draw attention to the fact that the last task, summarized as find Bill from May 12th, is the one that participants struggled with the most. If we want to draw attention to that bar, we can use a contrasting color for it and then leave the rest in gray. Next, using an informative title is by far the easiest big impact change you can make in your chart. Titles should not merely describe the data, they should describe its implication. Don't force viewers to search for your takeaway, draw your conclusion for your audience. Sticking with our quantitative usability testing example, we have a very bland, uninformative title, Success Rates by Task. If our goal is to show that one of the tasks had much lower success rates than the others, all we have to do is say that in the title. Participants struggled to find past bills. If we want to make this even easier to process, we can take it a step further by using the same color blue on the key phrase in the title, Find Past Bills. That way, we're connecting the title to the data value of interest. Finally, the last element for creating contrast is optional, callouts. These are annotations that add additional information to your chart. Callouts might take the form of additional text or tooltips. Callouts can be particularly helpful when showing time-based data in a line chart. In these situations, we might want to add a callout to help people see where important events, like redesigns, sales, or external events, impacted the metrics. Let's imagine we're working on an e-commerce site that sells children's clothing and toys. We have physical stores in addition to our e-commerce site, and we've been tracking average order value, or AOV, over the past few years. Average order value increased slightly after a redesign in December 2019, but spiked substantially when the 2020 pandemic caused booming e-commerce demand. We can add callout annotations on top of the chart to help our viewers see and remember where those events occurred. Designing a chart to emphasize a finding is not the same as manipulating a chart to make it misleading. Don't abuse these techniques to trick your audience. Don't try to obscure findings that contradict your expectations or do not serve your goals. It's always best to be honest and upfront about your data. If there's a data point or a finding that doesn't conform with your expectations, don't ignore it. Transparency is always the best policy when it comes to reporting research. The easiest way to know if people will understand your data charts is to test them, just like you would with any other design. Show a member of your intended audience, maybe a team member or a stakeholder, your data visualization. Ask them to summarize their interpretation.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.